Police in South Africa are boosting their efforts in the fight against drunk driving. They're threatening to jail offenders. Driving drunk is a major problem there, costing thousands of lives and billions of dollars every year. CCTV's Travis Andrews has more.
Drink and driving don't mix. Everyone knows it, and yet, in this part of South Africa alone, the Western Cape, more than 100 people are killed every month in alcohol-related accidents. And everyone here has a story to tell.
I've seen quite a lot of people do stupid things in Cape Town, and you've got to keep your eyes open very much when you're driving in Cape Town, because you never know what they're going
to do. Drunk driving scares me, because not only it's dangerous for me, it's dangerous for all of us road users. You see, a bike, it's not stable, like a car. Anything can hit you and you are down, you are injured or dead, you see.
When I'm driving on the streets and I come across a drunk driver, it's definitely not a nice experience, man, because someone else's negligence could maybe cause your own life, man. And you are maybe sober behind the wheel, while then the next person is maybe drunk, but then they survive and you don't.
Cape Town's response is roadblocks and the threat of prison.
We have weekend alcohol blitzes every weekend, carried out by provincial traffic services, who work 24 hours a day on this particular issue, with enforcement operations at various hotspots that we know drunk driving to occur. Just this past weekend, we carried out over 30 enforcement roadblocks and screened over 1,000 drivers for alcohol in particular, resulting in about 37 arrests.
Spot checks on motorists are becoming more frequent too. What's really needed, though, is a change of attitude. Statistics show that payday is by far the deadliest period to be a road user. It's a time when motorists and even inebriated pedestrians make their roads particularly dangerous. Visible policing can only be part of the solution. Until we change our ways, for many drivers here, their next journey could be their last. Travis Andrews, CCTV, Cape Town.